Ready, continuing on. Competitor number 7 is LaVonya Bennett, a counseling psychology PhD student who will be presenting Influence of Positive and Negative Diversity Interactions on Psychological Well-Being.
The historical context around race in the United States has not only made people fearful of being called racist, but fearful of sharing their experiences with racism. We've seen a resurgence in student activism, and this has been echoed across the nation, much of which mirrors what we saw during the Civil Rights era. Current research shows us that students who experience racism on campus have greater negative implications for learning outcomes, retention, and the development of trauma-like symptoms in students of color. This is of particular interest to me as a psychologist in training because it wouldn't be implausible to have a client state that they've experienced racism but refer to it as mundane or commonplace. But meanwhile, that same client will present with symptoms of anxiousness, excessive worry, reliving the racist experience, or a plethora of other symptoms that might speak to the presence of trauma. So I sought out to investigate the relationship between psychological well-being and diversity interactions. To do this, I utilized a national longitudinal data set where I randomly selected a total of 2,000 Black, Asian, Latinx, and white students. I used a single group regression analysis, which is a statistical model that looks at the relationship between variables. The most important variables for me were diversity interaction and psychological well-being. I found that negative diversity interactions significantly and negatively influence psychological well-being for Black, Latinx, Asian, and white students. Conversely, I found that positive diversity interactions significantly and positively influence psychological well-being only for the white students in our sample. The implications from my research have importance in two areas. First is that historically, colleges and universities' efforts to institute diversity and inclusion have not considered the needs of students of color. Research shows us that students of color are often called on to serve as peer educators on race relations for their white peer counterparts. However, my research challenges this approach and asserts that students of color need to be included and centered in these diversity and inclusion efforts. The second area of implication for my research is that college administrators and presidents must complete quality campus climate surveys. However, presidents and administrators have repeatedly stated that they're fearful of completing these surveys, that they're fearful of the results that they may find, that they're fearful of the light that it might shed on the university. But the findings from my research challenge that fear and challenge university administrators to act on the same resilience that they expect of their students. The findings from my research challenge university administrators to not let another voice go unheard. Thank you.